Hello, Nanagir, and welcome back to Path of Exile. We are playing our Dominatrix, who has acquired Facebreakers, and as a result, monsters kind of melt away before us. So let's summon some spirits so we can actually use some of the corpses to get our zombies back up. So, these Facebreakers, 642% more unarmed physical damage. It's a low-end damage roll. I mean, it can roll up to 800%. But this only cost me one chaos. So this is a very good deal early on. And Infernal Blow is now 147 DPS. Well, before it was about 60 using a middling weapon. So we are finally getting somewhere. Also, stop running. Oops, thank you. Clumsy me. So, Act 2. Let's finally get serious. Couple things also. The bone offering kind of conflicts with blowing up all the corpses. That's a serious problem, actually. And bone offering is gonna give the minions a buff to make them block better. And when they do block, they actually gain some life back. As a defensive item, it's pretty good. Problem though is if I kill all the corpses, there's not gonna be a lot left. Oh. We'll make do. Combination of punching things and just summoning skulls and Perandus horde. Okay. Perandus treasury. Oh wow. Chaos orb. That replaces the one we spent on the Facebreaker. Okay, so, final shield note. Now we're gonna go grab Mind Barrier, then Cruel Preparation, and we're gonna go for Death Attunement. And this is actually one I want to get pretty quickly, so we'll just go weave through that. Because regenerating minion life is good. Makes him stay alive a bit longer. Okay, here's the road, there's the exit. Excellent. Let's see. Yes, you leave corpse. That means we can claim it. I had to move some things around a little bit. Currently using a kite shield for Infernal Blow. Shouldn't have picked that up. Because nope, it has armor, it has evasion, but because it's armor and energy shield, and as a result, it's pretty good at rolling things that are blue and red, which is what we use for the Link. So let's go for Crane first. See, Bravallo is probably gonna come from up there. Let's say hello. Hello there, Bravallo. Here, let me punch you a couple times. Bye bye. Torch catch with a 3-link blue. That looks like it might actually be an upgrade. Excellent. Most excellent. That actually means I can move my minions around. And I need more corpses. Always need more corpses, but now especially. Good, we got 5 zombies again. Hello there, Theamoga. You are pretty much it. Are you casting Desecrate or something? Or was that just something close to it? Ooh, Iron Ring. Ruby Rings. Let's have a look. Maybe we need good Iron Rings. Currently, this is basically where most of our damage comes from, along with this one. And we don't really have anything else. I guess it's a good thing that they are going for my pets. Downside is they're running straight past me, so it's harder to actually hit them. I can do attacks too. Let's just unleash the spirits. Unleash the spirits within. Strongbox, gem cutter, strongbox. Nice. I could have enchanted that. Should have enchanted that, but. Ah well. Also? Ah, already got using greater ones. Need one more. Hey, cowards. Yes. Heavy strike, ancestral protector, firestorm, and leap slam. Ancestral protector is an interesting one. Since I have a slot available, and well, punchy totem is better than not having anything. There's a waypoint.
When I'm ready and not before.
Oh, what a nice flow of events. Waypoint, and then instantly we walk into Creighton's base. So, as with most of my builds, we're gonna help Oak and kill Creighton. Just more clarity. Excellent. Just summon a bunch of spirits. That way we actually preserve the corpses so we can erase them. Punchy totem. Then. Oh. Stop running around, you bugger. Split. Okay, thank you.
It's kind of disappointing, really. I usually like rats.
Okay. Rusted spike for selling, not for actually equipping. So torture cage were already. Ah, of course, yeah. Now we're also being picky about sockets. If it doesn't have a 3 or more sockets, I don't see the regular items anymore. Which is a very decent way to just filter through items. Starting level 25, I'll actually have the filter be even more strict and only show 4 socket items. This is fairly okay. 22 energy shield with some life regen.
Going.
And then we have the sorting box. So items that I picked up that are specifically for equipping, I'll actually have a dedicated tab for. like I used to have. This one can be sorted afterwards. Okay, so that was great then. Back to the crossroads and into the Chamber of Sin. More zombies. Easy how quickly they die once exposed to some damage. That's a very poor chain belt. I don't want it. Hello there, Xandra the Blood Drinker. You use Blood Rage, don't you? Yep, you do. Also, he splits pretty hard. That's a kill off the head staver, yep. Let's see, not about Iron Ring, yes, yes, please. And a coral amulet. Let's ID them both, see what they are. Eh. Those items make me sad. Let's murder these. Is there anything corpse-like around here? Not really. Okay, what is summoning that? It's blast rain, isn't it? It's not even a rain of arrows, it's a blast rain. Yep. So that's those archers in the back. Yes, he kills them. How many corpses are there? 3, 4, 5. Good, good, good. Let's see, silken vest, that's a 3-link. Might be worth upgrading. Also, skill point. Let's see, we had this, now we're gonna go up in the tree. And into the Chamber of Sins we go. Let's see, level 15, I'm 18. Slightly overleveled, which is good. Gives me a little bit of an edge.
The air stinks of thaumaturgy. I could learn a thing or two here.
Splits! Splits! Let's see how easy it is to navigate through this time. So, just teleport into the middle, kill them all. Ooh. And there is a tomb. Or a school. And a noisy car outside. Or noisy bike, I think. That's more like a break. Hello there, Alain. Again, Xandra Blood Drinker. Let's punch you in the face. Thank you. Before you kill any more of my zombies. Greater life. Oh, it's blue. Must be good. Okay. Is this greater? It removes bleeding. Don't have a bleeding removal yet, so that's worth taking. See, punch down a totem. Makes it even better to punch them. Can these guys do quite some damage? That was some blocked path, so we go back. I'm very curious to see how this build is gonna hold up while leveling, especially in a challenge league like this. So far, pretty good damage, but we are a bit squishy against the Perandus hordes. Then again, even the Earthquaker had some issues with the Perandus hordes early on, and that town turned out to be pretty much of a monster of a tank. So we'll see. This build is not really complete until we have Zealot's Oath and a Stone Golem. Until then, we are rather flimsy because we don't really have a lot of regen. So let's do a quick count stop, empty our pockets before we move on. There, Chamber of Sets. Mute Wind Trackers. Eighteen chain belts, that's pretty decent. Don't really have a lot of resistance against lightning, do we? No, 4%. So Fidelitas is gonna hurt. He's gonna hurt. The thing is, I always have the skulls to fall back on. Especially this early, while I'm still rather flimsy and not in the final build. It's gonna be rather useful. On the other hand, if I just hit him hard enough and fast enough, I might not need to focus a lot on defense. You only need defense if your offense is not strong enough. If you knock them out before they can lay a finger on you, you don't need defenses and you can get around with just 1 HP. Problem is, reliably killing them before they kill you is pretty darn tricky. Die, die, die. Thank you. Righteous fire. Yeah, let's not. Not with this build. Oh, Burn the Witch, it does snow feel natural, but let's not go with it. Okay, now that I've said that, Burn the Witch, it does sound like a very good start of a build. Even if it's just because of Burn the Witch. You burn the witch and then she'll take revenge. Then she'll show you. Hello there, Ash Lassard. Here, have some spirits. And a punch. Boom. A middling ruby. Okay, this looks like the passage to... Yes, this is the fight. Also, we need to kill a couple of minions because, well, we only have 3 zombies. Which is too to few.
That thing, it slaughtered everyone. Help me.
Of course there's a Perandus horde here. Of course there's a Perandus horde here. Why not? Why wouldn't there be a Perandus horde here? Of course. That's gonna be painful. Here, I have a punchy totem as well. That will just focus them a little bit. So if I go in here, I can just explode them. Ow, they hurt. They really hurt. Ow. 1, 2, 3. Ow. Let's not stand in a circle, shall we? Okay, So the infinite ghostly legions of the Perandus hordes, they are gonna be the end of me at some point. It's always just showing up when they are not wanted. Okay, I think I pulled them away far enough. Here, I have a totem. I'll just kill you. Here, have some more of these. Yes. Okay, so that's one threat dealt with. Onwards, next threat. Here, you have some skulls. Then I'll raise your corpse. Aren't you supposed to be dead? It's open, that's good. So yay, we have a strange device and a baleful gem. So extra block chance, which is good, 24% now. Have a chat with Helena. And then yes, we have all five zombies again. Excellent. Let's look for the trial. So there's nothing special about this room. Well, this is the Flashback League, and on top of Perandus, it does make things interesting. Ooh, 30% ruby ring. Oh, having the Perandus Horde on top of Fidelitas, it does make the encounter more challenging. Actually, no, testing your defenses against that much damage, it's good. It's only a taste, of course, of the damage that we'll be facing later on as things intensify, especially once Beyond League gets added. It is my favorite league, of course, Beyond. Just always having the threat of having Haste or any of his other demonic buddies just pop out of any strongbox or anything else that just gonna cause lots of dead enemies in a very short time. It does make things interesting. And there is the challenge, the trial. 2, 3, 4, and 5, just refreshing all the minions. And then we go in. Ah, spinning razor blades of doom. Okay, just walk after it. Then we teleport over. And let's just reclaim some corpses here. Let's not explode too many of them. We might need them to resurrect. Okay. They're out of sync now, that's good. Means we can just follow. Ow. Ooh, another Valorb. That's two in a row. Okay, they are out of sync now. That's also good. Follow. There's only one. Oh no. I'm just like confused here. But whatever. We made it through. And that's the second trial done.
The former is wisdom.
For Dumbed area, might as well leave. So, Herald of Thunder Ash. Ooh, Desecrate. Yes, please. I want Desecrate. So, put that one there, put this one there. And slowly our bar is filling up with some of our final skills. Once we get Spectres, we kick out the Ancestral Protector. Because we just need the casting slot. Well, so far, so good. So, with that, I'm gonna thank you very much for watching. Next episode, I'm gonna do the crypts and then we head over to the west side of town to have a chat with Alira, our fellow witch, and the Spider Queen. So, hope to see you again next time. Bye bye.